So we successfully completed unit one, and we will move ahead with unit two, first chapter, that is known as Principles of Inheritance and Variation. So yesterday we discussed about the introductory part of this chapter. We will wait for 2 more minutes so that others can join, and then we will proceed with the class. By the meantime, if anyone wish to ask any kind of question, you are most welcome. The way every day we start our discussion about with a revision of whatever we studied last day. So today also, without any exception, we will discuss our start our discussion with whatever we learned yesterday. So we talked about the chapter called Principles of Inheritance and Variation. In this chapter, we learned about what are the things we learned about? Who is going to tell me now? We learned the definition of, yes, Dish.
Ma'am, we learned inheritance, genetics, and the heredity definitions, and some
Apart from
questions
that,
that you have.
we talked about variation also. So we learned about inheritance definition. We learned about definition of variation. We learned that why variation is required and why variation is so important from the point of view of making a specific type of species adaptable. Apart from that, we learned about that new branch that is called genetics, and we learned the definition of heredity. Isn't it? So today we I hope if all these definitions are clear to your mind, we will start our discussion today with the great work of Mendel. Should we move ahead? Can I take it in a way that you understood these definitions? Can we move ahead? Okay. So today we will talk about a person whose name is Mendel. Mendel is actually the surname. It is Gregor Johann Mendel, and he was born in 1822. Obviously, you don't have to remember this date. Then also, I wish to mention this date because, give me 1 moment. Sorry for the connectivity issue. Actually, so while I'm mentioning this 1822, because you know that the structure of DNA was discovered in the year 1953. So when Mendel performed his work on genetics, he didn't know what is responsible for transmission of character from one generation to another. So you can understand how difficult it was from his point of view without knowing the molecular basis that how a character is determined, by what type of thing character is determined, what is the mechanism of transmission of character. he planned his experiment, and let me tell you, Mendel's experiment is one of the most successful experiment, because many of his hypotheses are accepted without any change. Some minor alteration is there, but most of it is accepted without any change. And he almost spent 7 years for his experiment. So you can understand, it's not a 1 year, 2 year, it's 7 years he spent for this experiment. So basically, he was an Austrian monk. Monk means, you know, the person who preaches religion. But at that time, not many like monks were known for their interest in subjects like science and others. And at the background of charge only, he got the opportunity to plant these trees and everything. Rather to say saplings of pea plant, scientific name Pisum sativum. For his experiment. Now here, when we talk about Mendel's experiment, I don't know why Mendel is so successful. And Mendel's experiment, in spite of no discovery at that time in this regard, he was so accurate in predicting that data. It's really a mystery. And I don't know, we should give credit to that by chance factor he was successful, or his approach towards experiment is such a reason for his success. I must tell you that he performed an experiment of genetics. With this plant, and he was fortunate enough in selection of pea plant. So what were the advantages of selecting pea plant? Can anyone tell? What are the advantages? Fast. Yes, Veda, Yesha?
Ma'am, it grows very fast.
So you can say fast growth rate. Actually, we should not say fast growth rate. We can say that short lifespan. They have very short lifespan. So, while committing this type of experiments, it is very, very important for a person to observe several generations. And in case of Mendel, it was possible because the lifespan of the plant was very short. So what was the advantage? The advantage was that Mendel can study several generations of this plant. कंसिडर करो, अगर उसने हाथी का लाइफ स्पैन देखना चाहा होगा तो एलिफेंट्स गिव बर्थ टू देयर ऑफस्प्रिंग वंस इन 14-15 इयर्स, तो फिर कैसे वो मोर देन वन जनरेशन देख पाए इन हिज लाइफ टाइम. सो दैट्स दैट इज वन डेफिनेटली वन एडवांटेज. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट एनीथिंग एल्स?
Ma'am, it is easy to grow anywhere with very little care.
So easy to grow as well as small size is a very big factor. So as the size of the plant is very small and it is very easy to handle, you can grow number of plants in a very, what I can say, a small place, many number of plants can be grown. Okay, apart from that,
they show visible characters?
Very good. So there was presence of visible contrasting characters. We all know that Mendel got enough opportunity to find out the presence of visible characters. Like these are seven characters. We will talk about it later on. But one thing, it must have to be chosen by Mendel by looking into the different options, that in case of pea plant, the visible contrasting characters are available for experiment. But one thing which is occurred by chance is these seven contrasting character bearing genes locate into different chromosomes. So here Mendel was lucky that so no linkage was there. During our course of looking into this chapter, we will be able to find out what is linkage. So linkage is a phenomenon where due to close proximity of the genes, they almost get inseparable during the process of crossing over. Okay, so during the process of separation of the gene via crossing over, they are never linked because all of them are located into separate chromosomes. So this is something which is a great character that is by chance Mendel got advantage of this. Can you suggest any more other characters of
pea plant perform self pollination?
So definitely, so they as they perform self pollination. So it is as they go for self pollination. So they are generally true breeding. Mixing of characteristics is not that much required. And apart from that, the big flower size. Promote, or rather to say, I can say, make cross pollination easy. And hybrids are fertile too. So we need to understand this part, that we know that plants are categorized into self-pollinator and cross-pollinator. So in many cases, it is observed that even if the plant is it is a cross-pollinator plant, or even if it is self-pollinator, the other type is not successfully obtained in case of those plants. For example, if plant are cross-pollinator, it's having self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Okay, but many a times, self-pollinator plants are also having some kind of special features where even if cross pollination is there, the hybrid produced the dust are not fertile. They are sterile. So it was a lucky thing and it was a good thing that in case of Physum sativum, self pollination is possible. And if you remove the male part, that is, if you remove the androecium by emasculation, then you can go for cross pollination as per your own wish, because the hybrid produced by cross pollination is fertile. So the character can be transmitted to the next generation. Is it clear, class?
Yes, ma'am.
So these are like advantages of choosing pea plant for the experiment. Next thing is I just want to talk about a very, very important aspect which may not be discussed much in textbook, but students get confused while we teach this part. These are two terminologies. Main confusion faced by students is, are they same or are they different? Because if we look into the dictionary meaning of these two words, and when we use them in communication English, we use them similarly. But like in case of Mendel's experiment, they carry a thin line of difference between them. These two terminologies are the difference between characters and traits. So what are these characters and traits? Let me give you one example. Character means feature of individual. In case of trait, it is distinguishable and detectable variant of characters.
Ma'am, can we say traits are subdivision of characters?
You can say, definitely. Let me explain with a what I can say, variation with an example. When we talk about this, we can say, for example, let me write down the names of different characters that is taken into consideration by Mendel. For example, if we talk about the seed shape. So here in this trait, there were two types of trait that was observable in case of pea plant. One is dominant and other one is recessive. And here we can say location. So we can say that in case of seed shape, two variation was possible. One was round and the other one was wrinkled. And chromosome, which is actually bearing this character, is located in here I will write chromosome number. So it was located in chromosome number 7. Second character we can consider seed color. In this case, two options are there. One is yellow and the other one was green. This is located in chromosome number 1. Third is flower color. So it is violet and white. Although it is located, genes for this color is located in chromosome number 1. These two genes responsible for seed color and flower color are located at quite a large distance between them. So generally the linkage is not observed in this case. Fourth one is pod shape. So what is pod? हमें पता है मटर की हम फली खरीदते हैं ना, ऐसा एक चीज रहता है जिसके अंदर सीड्स रहते हैं. We call it मटर फली. So that holds thing inside which the matter or the pea granules are located is called pod. So when we are talking about pod shape, we can say it is full or we can use this term inflated, means it is fluffy from inside. There is no gap. For example, if you look into it, it's having structure like this. But the other one is called constricted. Here, it's having structure like this. So wherever the pea is not there, that part is quite there, it will have a deep groove inside. So this character is present in case of chromosome number 4. Next character that is obviously very important, it's pod color. Pod color can be green and yellow, and it is located in chromosome number 5. So chromosome number 5 decides the color of the pod, and color of the pod is the character, and green and yellow are two traits of this specific character. Okay, now let us have a look into the next character, that is flower position. Flower position can be axial or axial and terminal. So what is the meaning of this? I will tell you. Consider if this is a plant which has branches like this, and leaves are coming out of these branches. In case the flower is present in the axil, this angle created by the branch of the plant as well as the main stem is called axil. If flower is present at this axil part, then this type of flower is known as axial flower. But if this is axial, but if flower is present at the tip of the plant, then we call it terminal. In case of terminal, it's not always tip of the main stem. Even if consider at the tip of the any branch also, if the flower is present, then also we call it terminal. Okay, so I guess the difference between terminal position and the axial position is clear to everyone. Is it clear, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so the last characteristic that is most discussed about characteristics, that is called stem height. So, stem height, very simply, it is called tall and wide. Now, I just would like to mention here that I want to highlight this characters, distinguishable and detective. Remember, if two plants are having near difference of 1 or 2 centimeters, we cannot say that out of them the one which is having height a few centimeters more will be tall and the other one will be a bit short. The difference between height in these plants needs to be having a range. Because if you observe plants, no two plants will have generally same height. So there should be a remarkable difference in the height between two types of plants. Then only we can group them as tall and tall. So these are 7 contrasting characters, and luckily, as I mentioned, that most of the cases they never get linked. So Mendel was lucky and his experiment was almost flawless. Is it clear to everyone the difference between characters and traits? Because these are the terminologies we are going to use better. Is it clear? Should we move ahead? Class?
Yes, ma'am.
Only one person? Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, we will definitely move ahead. But I just want to say a few things. So, from this idea of choosing 7 contrasting characters, I must tell, we need to jot down the points for the reason behind success of Mendel. So if we want to jot down the points for reason behind success of Mendel, somewhere for which he was lucky and for some like it was his wise decision. So can we come upon a discussion where we can find out the reason behind success of Mendel? What was the reason? Why do you think like Mendel was so much successful in performing such kind of experiment? What is that radical decision he made which like makes this experiment till date we studied? And this is the basics of genetics. That's why Mendel is known as the father of genetics till date. So what was his radical decision that was made by Mendel?
He observed only one character at a time.
No, beta. That's not correct. Then there wouldn't have been dihybrid and trihybrid cross, isn't it? Not observe one character at a time. That's not the correct thing. I can understand what you want to communicate, but you need to rephrase your sentence. So what is the reason for Mendel's success? Yes, Dish.
Ma'am, he had seen all the traits individually.
Individually means what do you want to mean by individual?
Ma'am means one by one.
Yes, correct. Generally, when you want to see the data, you actually do it one by one. But let me tell you, if Ahmedabad Municipal Corporation want to go for a survey or want to present a data of any kind of, let me say, pollution level at different part of Ahmedabad, spreading of COVID at different part of Ahmedabad, don't you think there should be a specific method of doing it, or we need to take help of one subject without which correct presentation of data is of no use? How will you ensure that the person who is collecting the data is errorless, and even if there is error, what is the percentage of error, and how will you ensure that it is unbiased data? क्योंकि कंसिडर करो, अगर मैं आपकी क्लास में जाके आपको पूछ रही हूँ आपके क्लास का अच्छा बच्चा कौन है, आई एम एन एकेडमिशियन, आई वॉन्ट टू नो अबाउट द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर गुड इन एकेडमिक्स. मेनी अ टाइम्स इट इज ऑब्जर्व दैट विदाउट मेजरिंग देयर इंटेलिजेंस और एबिलिटी और देयर स्कोर्स, और इवन समटाइम्स व्हाट वी डू, वी लुक इनटू वन एग्जामिनेशन एंड वी से कि अच्छा ये बच्चा अच्छा है. So if we want to avoid such kind of error, what we need to do? हमें क्या करनी पड़ेगी? What method we need to do? कैसे analyze करेंगे तो by using which method we will be able to say that this data is having this much standard error and this is unbiased data. Anyone, any idea?
Ma'am, can you repeat the question?
I asked, what is the radical reason for success of Mendel? Which is the main reason? There were many reasons, but there is one reason by which he scientifically handled the data. So what with the help of what we can scientifically analyze data, kaun si branch of science hoti hai jisme they teach us how to handle the data? You studied it in your lower grades, even if you are not having maths in 11-12, you studied it in your lower grades. Which analysis we do to make sure that the data is unbiased and flawless? And even if flaw is there, we can calculate the percentage of flaw.
Algebraic?
No, statistical analysis. See, one very bad news I want to share. Many of you must have opted for biology because you hate maths. Let me tell you, if you want to do research in any field, leave biology. Even if you want to do research in English or history or sociology, geology, whatever may be the thing, if you want to present a data, hum sirf bolne se no one is going to believe that data. You need to give average. You need to give standard deviation. You need to present standard error. All these data, his first strong point is he applied statistical method. So he applied statistical methods for data analysis. This is the biggest and strongest point of Mendel. Why? Because beta, when we look into a single point for observing or for concluding something, it is always biased by a single individual. For example, if I see the result of a student for only one examination, obviously I may be faulty. Maybe at that time the child was not well. Maybe at that time there was some problem. But that doesn't mean the child is not a good student. So we need to see series of data. We need to see the deviation of child. What is the deviation? Okay, in previous two examination, there is improvement. In previous two examination, first one is very high, second one is very low. So there is a fluctuating pattern. So we need to present a statistical method. This was the biggest advantages of Mendel's approach. Second thing is, he actually recorded data accurately. And keep records of them. As a plant breeder, with my personal experience, because I, during my PhD, I had plant breeding experiment. This is the part which is most difficult part. So plants honge aapke saamne, har ek plant ki jab aap height naapoge na, it is really irritating. And you need to note it down with patience in a sheet where all data are recorded accurately. Koi ulta pulta hona nahi chahiye. Then only, if you are not recording data accurately, then statistical analysis will not help you. Third thing is that the large sample size. Do you think if I want to ask the feelings of grade 12 students, I covered 2-3 schools of Ahmedabad and published the data, okay, this is how grade 12 students are feeling nowadays. Do you think it will be accurate? We should do like this. Class, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
We should do like this. If I want to truly know this year batch, I'm not talking about new grade 12. I'm talking about the grade 12. Because this is a unique situation we teachers as a vice principal I'm facing. We have this year 2 to grade 10, 2 to grade 12. Chalo, 10th ka to CBSE problem is sorted. We are going to promote them and there is a method of scoring also. For grade 12, we still have 2 grade 12s. Isn't it? The one of 2021 and you people are the one which is 21-22. So if I want to ask about the opinion of students and I chose 3 schools of Ahmedabad and I wanted to ask how they feel about this uncertainty about examination. Do you think I am going to do a justice to the collection of data? Is it correct to simply asking 2-3 children of each 2-3 schools of Ahmedabad and publish this data? This is how Indian students of grade 12 CBSE feeling. Do you think it will be correct?
No, ma'am.
Because obviously in Ahmedabad people must be feeling like that. In Palanpur people must be feeling differently. In Surat people must be feeling differently. So while doing experiment, the large sample size means how many samples you are recording. More the samples you record, more accurate your data is. Because you are getting maximum variation and you are recording variation. So Mendel, as pea plants were small and they had very less lifespan, he had a very, high number of plants cultivated in the field and he got large sampling size. So that's why his recorded data recording was obviously very difficult, but large sample size was the reason why accuracy of recorded data was very high. Any other suggestion? So basically, these are the reasons for success of Mendel. Apart from that, he studied them for several generations. That too, every plant breeders do. And as I said, that he was lucky that linkage was not there in any of the genes. So if this part is understood, can we move ahead to the experiment, actual experiment of Mendel, what he did actually?
Yes, ma'am.
So we will move, look into a few terminologies. These are very, very important terminologies, and apart from that, we will discuss about a few extra terminologies. And I know that many of them you studied earlier. Many of them I discussed when I was in a normal mode of classroom, we discussed. Please let me know if I miss anyone, any of these terminologies, and you require any clarification about them. So basically, we will start our discussion with the definition of allele. Allele is the abbreviation of the word allelomorph. So what is allele? What do we mean by the word allele? Yes, I can see two hands raised. One is Esha, other is Mishka. Esha answered several questions today, so I will give opportunity to Mishka. Yes, Mishka.
Ma'am, a pair of genes present in same location of the homologous chromosomes and the code for same character.
So these are pair of genes located at same loci of homologous chromosome and the code for same characters. See, this like definition is generally, if you look into any kind of textbook or notes, generally this definition is restricted into pair of genes, code for contrasting, like same characters. Let me elaborate it a bit here so that it will be easy for you. For traits of same character. So generally, while definition is provided in most of the textbook and everywhere, they mention about these two lines, that they are pair of genes and they code for the traits of the same character. For example, height, two alleles are there, one are coding for tallness, another is dwarfness. Or maybe both can code for TT. It may be capital T, small t. It may be small t, small t. Why do I need to speak about this? Because it will clarify your concept. It is observed that alleles are always present in the same locus of homologous chromosome. So what do we mean by homologous chromosome? Here comes the definition of homologous chromosome. Who is going to tell me about this? You must have heard about it while you were studying cell division chapter, isn't it? What is homologous chromosome?
Ma'am, it is a type of chromosome where same parents are there.
Same parents are there? No. Some much more elaborate answer of this question. Two hands, yes. Yesha, you tell me this time. What do we mean by homologous chromosome?
Ma'am, they have gene for same character at the same location.
So what? How can we call homologous chromosome? What are the conditions of two chromosomes to be homologous? First of all, they must be inherited. So homologous chromosome are actually pair of chromosome. So that means if in a homologous chromosome pair, in a homologous chromosome pair, if one is obtained from father, the other one will be obtained from mother. Understood? Agar ek father se mila hai, to dusra kisse milega? Mother se milega. It is compulsory. What is the second condition? Generally, homologous chromosomes have same size and structure. If the chromosome let me not write here the word same, because in case of sex chromosome, X and Y, they are homologous, but they don't have same size. So similar size and structure. Why similar? Because if one chromosome is submetacentric, the other will be submetacentric only. If one is metacentric, other will be metacentric only. I hope you know the classification of chromosomes. It depends on the position of centromere. I hope you know it better. All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
So they must be having similar size and structure. And third point is the point which is mentioned by Esha is, these homologous chromosomes, they have alleles at same location. So consider if this chromosome will have capital T gene here, this will have small t gene here, or capital T, whatever it is. But the genes responsible for a character will be located at the same position of the homologous chromosome. And if you want to consider the fourth point, they go for crossing over. It's always homologous chromosome which go for crossing over during the meiosis cell division. Look into this characteristics carefully and let me know if you have doubt in any one of them. So I will take silence as a good sign और फिर हम आगे बढ़ेंगे. Is it all right? The definition of homologous chromosome is clear to everyone? Class?
Yes, ma'am.
है ना? चलो. So allele definition is clear to everyone? Allele are what? Actually they are what? Pair of genes. है ना? So basically they are what? Genes. Now I just want to have an idea. I know many of you will be able to tell me what is DNA, what is gene, what is this genetic material. What do we mean by chromosome? Yesha is raising hand. And what do we mean by chromatin reticula? So are they same? Yes, Yesha, you can start describing them one by one. So first of all, let me know, are they same? Are they same? If I look into the chemical composition of them, are they same?
Ma'am, basically they are same and means it's just the subdivisions of one another.
Can we call it subdivision? What do you think, class? Then why too many names of the same thing? Why? See, they are not actually same. Although all of them are having basic components same, but they are not same. They carry different meanings. So let us understand the meaning of each of them. Yes, Yesha, what is DNA?
Ma'am, DNA is a genetic material because it decides the characters.
So it is full form is deoxyribonucleic acid. So what is it? What is the DNA? So it is the chemical form to store data. So what is DNA? It is a chemical form to store data of character and transmit to next generation. जैसे आप लोग कंप्यूटर के डेटा किस पे स्टोर करते हो, हाउ यू स्टोर द डेटा? ये जो अभी हम जूम लेक्चर्स ले रहे हैं, आप ये लेक्चर मैं यूट्यूब में डालूंगी, फिर आप लोग इसको देख पाएंगे बाद में, या फिर मैं मेरे कंप्यूटर के हार्ड डिस्क में रख रही हूँ, तो हाउ आई एम स्टोरिंग दिस डेटा? सिमिलर वे इफ आई एम सेइंग कि एक इंसान की हाइट देखो, उसके फादर कितने लंबे हैं, उनका बेटा भी उतना ही लंबा हो, मम्मी इतनी गोरी है ना, लड़की भी उतनी गोरी हो. सो हाउ वी कंफर्म दैट how that color of skin, height of person, or maybe the texture of the hair, that if the hair is straight, if the hair is curly. All these characters are stored in the form of a chemical substance, and that chemical substance is DNA. Is it clear to all of you? And when it is passed from one generation to other generation, it is passed in the form of DNA. Let us talk about the genetic material. When while Esha was describing DNA, she said that it is the genetic material. So, does our genetic material only have DNA? Yesha, what do you think? So, what is genetic material? This is collection of nucleic acid and protein which determines character. Now you will say कि मैम आप ये तो सेम ही हुआ, but remember here I use the word nucleic acid, not the DNA. Because beta, genetic material can be RNA too. In case of virus, for example, most of the animal virus have RNA as a genetic material, including this one, COVID-19. So we cannot say that DNA is always the genetic material. That's why genetic material can be DNA. It can be RNA. Some special cases, the characters from one generation to another generation transmitted via protein. I will teach you about prion proteins. They are kind of self-replicatory proteins. So genetic material must be having nucleic acid. It's not always necessary that they will have the DNA. So what is chromosomes? Let's talk about chromosome. What do we mean by chromosome? Who is going to tell me what is chromosome? This time I want anyone else to speak, not Esha. Esha, what is the correct pronunciation of your name? Yes, it's Esha.
Esha.
Esha. So I will not ask Yesha, I will ask others. I taught this to everyone. Can you please tell me what do we mean by chromosome? Yes, Gia, you can speak better.
Ma'am, they are densely coiled DNA.
Very good. So we can call that they are densely coiled DNA around protein. So basically the DNA molecule, we will study about it in next chapter, that is molecular basis of inheritance, coiled around a specific substance And further, there is coiling to give you a stick-like structure, and this stick-like structure is none other than the chromosome. Okay, so each chromosome is having two chromatids. If you look into chromosomes, each chromosomes will be having two chromatids. So chromosomes are densely coiled DNA. So the next question that comes into mind is, why we require densely coiled DNA? Why we need to coil DNA? जैसा है वैसे ही अच्छा था ना. Why we need to coil them? And to be for your information, let me tell you, the chromosome number of a species is fixed. For example, we all are human beings. If I sequence my DNA, your DNA, Yesha's DNA, Jia's DNA, everyone DNA sequencing will be, a sequence of nitrogenous bases will be different. That's why I am having such characters like myself. Others are having characters like as far as coded by their DNA. But chromosome number of every human species, that is, will be 46. If there is more chromosome, is or are more chromosomes and less, that will be considered as abnormality. So ideally, human being must have 2N equal to 46 chromosome number. Same for pea plant, it is 14 chromosome number, 2N equal to 14. So this chromosome number of a species is fixed. I will come back again to my question that why DNA needs to be coiled around something. Who is going to answer this question? No one? Kosha, why so silent today? Mahi, Prachi, Shyama, Mishka, Nakshatra. Is Priyanshi not keeping well? She is not joining the class. Anyone knows about her? Because last time she said that she is not well. Class, are you there? Am I audible?
Chemistry class mein present thi.
Achha, achha. So chromatin reticulum, I want to ask why this another variation of uncoiled version of DNA is required. So can anyone give me the reason why chromosomes need to be coiled? Because chromatin reticulum is uncoiled DNA.
Ma'am, coil structure ensures the segregation of chromosome during cell division.
Very good. So actually, coiled structure ensure easy separation of chromosome. So basically, if cell is at the time of division, so chromosomes will be too much coiled and you can see them in the form of a stick. And this is called a stick-like chromosome structure. And if you look into the time when cell division is not occurring, and cell is actively participating for other events, the DNA is present in the form of chromatin reticulum, where it is present in the form of uncoiled or loose. You can understand this, that when we buy thread from shop, they are not given to us loose. They are always entangled around a rim made up of hard cardboard. उसके चारों ओर उसको लपेटा हुआ होता है ताकि वो एक दूसरे से उलझ ना जाए एंड दे शुड नॉट ब्रेक. सी डीएनए मींस डेटा. कंसीडर डीएनए इज वन पोर्शन. इफ इट इज डिलीटेड, अगर डीएनए का एक पोर्शन है जो किसी वजह से टूट गया और उस पार्ट में कोई इंपॉर्टेंट डेटा था, तो ऑब्वियसली दैट डेटा विल बी लॉस्ट फॉर दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म. कंसीडर करो एक प्लांट है जिसकी क्लोरोफिल फॉर्मेशन वाला डेटा चला गया, तो वो प्लांट तो सर्वाइव ही नहीं कर सकता है ना. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ टू अवॉइड सच काइंड ऑफ लॉस, टू अवॉइड सच काइंड ऑफ ब्रेकेज, एक्चुअली क्रोमैटिन रेटिकुलम इज यूज्ड जनरली व्हेन इट इज प्रेजेंट इन केस ऑफ नॉट सेल डिवीजन. इट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ क्रोमैटिन रेटिकुलम एंड व्हेन इट इज ड्यूरिंग द डिवीजन ऑफ सेल इट विल बी प्रेजेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ क्रोमोसोम. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? So we will look into the last definition, that is called gene. What do we mean by gene? Anyone? So gene is a part of chromosome. That can code for a protein. Why I am mentioning protein here? Because in our body, proteins actually finally control everything. So consider karo, if this is a chromosome which is actually made up by coiling of DNA, उसके इस पोजीशन में एक जीन रहेगा, इस पोजीशन में एक जीन रहेगा, दिस पोजीशन सम जीन्स विल बी देयर. सो व्हाट इज डी जीन? एक्चुअली दे आर नथिंग बट अ पार्ट ऑफ डीएनए दैट विल कोड फॉर अ प्रोटीन, बट फॉर आर बेनिफिट वी टर्म देम लाइक दिस, इफ टी इज दिस टी आर एक्स वाई. सो दीज आर डिफरेंट जीन्स. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट मे कम इन टू योर माइंड, कि जब हम क्रोमोसोम्स को माइक्रोस्कोप के नीचे देखते हैं, क्या जीन्स दिखते हैं? नो, दे आर नॉट विजिबल. बट फॉर आर बेनिफिट हम क्रोमोसोम की एक डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन बनाते हैं ऑन पेपर एंड पेन और इन स्क्रीन. एंड द वे आई प्लॉटेड द पोजिशन ऑफ जीन, द सेम वे द पोजिशन ऑफ जीन्स आर डन. And obviously they are very minute, so hum inki position ke liye we cannot use the units like regular units ke ek chromosome 10 meter ka hai, usme 1 meter itna. There are units to measure position of gene and these units are discovered by Morgan, so it is measured in terms of centimole. We will talk about that when we will discuss the linkage mapping concept. So is this clear to everyone part? So you can see that basically all of them are having DNA, but they don't carry the same meaning, isn't it? So class, if you give me green signal, then I will move ahead. Should we go ahead? With the rest of the definitions. So Yesha is saying, giving me thumbs up, so I will move ahead. Next part we will talk about other definitions. I observed one trend in the class that as the class start proceeding towards the last time, a few people leave. I want to ask a question here, is it the trend for every class or in biology if it is occurring? I need to know actually. So we will look into other definitions related to this chapter. First we will talk about the terminology called factor. Actually, at the time of Mendel, he didn't know much about the genes or DNAs and all these things. So he said that based on his observation, he concluded that something is passed from one generation to another. So something is passed from one generation to other. And there was a question mark in the mind of Mendel that what it is. Is it a protein or fat? Because discovery of genetic material was also done many years back. We will study that also. कैसे हमें पता चला that DNA is the genetic material and then we concluded that in some cases actually RNA can be. So what are factors? Factors are basically genes. Genes are similar to the factors. Mendel said that at that time that factors are the things which is responsible for transmitting character from one generation to another generation. Now, what are the characteristics of character? At the time of Mendel observed that one character may have two traits. That is trait one and trait two. And each one will have a gene which is representing them. There will be a gene which is representing them. So that means each character will have two genes. Okay. So for a character to be having distinguishable forms, it needs to have two genes. Now consider in case of a character, only one trait is there. Does that mean it will have only one gene? No. That means that it will have either this gene or this gene. So here comes the concept of homozygous and heterozygous. So what do we mean by homozygous? Homozygous means that if a variety have same genes for a specific character, we will call it homozygous. For example, capital T or small t. What do we mean by heterozygous? It is same, definition is same. I can even say that it is exactly same. We need to alter a few words. If a variety have different genes, for a specific character, we will call it heterozygous. And example is consider capital T, small t. Here the two contrasting character genes are present. That's why we call it heterozygous. So obviously every organism for one character minimum two genes should be there. Now these two genes can be either homozygous or it can be heterozygous. Understood everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Later on, it was observed that for a single character, here, that's why I mentioned this word minimum, because later on it was observed that it's not always that two genes are required. There may be more than two genes. For example, we will talk about polygenic inheritance in this chapter, where it's about having more than two genes for a single character, because variation is large, that's why more than two genes are used. Next is, Yesha asked me at the beginning of this class, what is the definition of genotype? Genotype means genetic construction. Constitution of organism. For example, here I am writing capital T, small t. So by writing these, I am mentioning the type and number of genes present here. So that is called genotype. So what is phenotype? Phenotype is something which is observable characters. For example, if I am mentioning tall and dwarf, then I can mention flower color, that is red and white, whatever it is. These are characters that we can see. We call these characters as phenotype. Is it clear? Genotype and phenotype definition?
Yes, ma'am.
So for genotype, it can be capital T, capital T, small t, anything is there. Even if small t can be genotype of someone. So genotype will tell us what are the types of genes present and what are the number of genes present in that organism. Next definition is dominant and recessive. So the character, or rather to say the phenotypic character, expressed in the phenotypic character expressed in hybrid or heterozygous is dominant and other one is recessive. For example, capital T is indicating tallness, small t is indicating dwarfness. Now, if I have a plant with genotypic combination at this, it will be a tall plant. So the character which will be expressed here is tallness. Although it has the gene of dwarfness, the dwarf character will not be expressed in this situation. dwarf character will not be expressed in the situation. इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि dwarf की जीन नहीं है, dwarf की जीन है, but क्योंकि tall character की दादागिरी ज्यादा है, capital T is the dominant gene, that's why its character is expressed and tall is dominant over in this case. Dwarfism is recessive. इट इज ऑब्जर्व्ड. आप अगर अपनी फैमिली हिस्ट्री में स्टडी करेंगे तो आप देखेंगे कभी कभी अजीबोगरीब कैरेक्टर्स आ जाता है जो शायद माँ बाप में नहीं है बट बच्चे पे आ जाता है. कैसे आता है? माँ बाप में नहीं है तो कहाँ से आता है? बिकॉज चाइल्ड इज इनहेरिटिंग द कैरेक्टर्स फ्रॉम मदर और फादर ओनली. सो कंसिडर इफ सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स और ग्रेट ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स इज ऑब्जर्व्ड इन द चाइल्ड. वो कैरेक्टर आने का सोर्स तो ग्रेट ग्रैंड पेरेंट इज नॉट गिविंग अस आवर द डीएनए डायरेक्टली. ऑब्वियसली द मींस ऑफ गिविंग इट इज मदर एंड फादर. सो हाउ इज दिस पॉसिबल दैट इन मदर एंड फादर दैट कैरेक्टर इज नॉट ऑब्जर्व? इट इज पॉसिबल बेटा बिकॉज दैट कैरेक्टर वॉज रिसेसिव इन केस ऑफ मदर एंड फादर एंड इन अ स्पेसिफिक कॉम्बिनेशन दैट इज नाउ एक्सप्रेस्ड. So such characters, it is dominant characters जो होते हैं, the characters which are dominant, they express even in heterozygous condition whereas recessive characters express only in homozygous condition. मतलब अगर हम कैपिटल टी ले रहे हैं और कैपिटल टी स्मॉल टी ले रहे हैं, दोनों की फिनोटाइप क्या होगा? दोनों का फिनोटाइप, देयर जीनोटाइप में भी डिफरेंट बट फिनोटाइप दोनों का क्या होगा? तो देखो जब डोमिनेंट कैपिटल टी है वो डोमिनेंट पोजीशन में भी एक्सप्रेस हो रहा है, रिसेसिव पोजीशन में भी एक्सप्रेस हो रहा है, उसको कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है कि वो डोमिनेंट है या रिसेसिव. वेयर एज स्मॉल टी तभी एक्सप्रेस होगा, दैट इज डॉर्फनेस तभी एक्सप्रेस होगा जब वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ तब जब वो होमोजाइगस कंडीशन में रहे. कैपिटल टी के प्रेजेंस में वो बेचारा डर जाता है और उसकी कैरेक्टर एक्सप्रेस नहीं होती. सो वी विल स्टॉप आवर लेक्चर हियर. अब तक मैंने जो पढ़ाया उससे रिलेटेड कोई डाउट बेटा? एनीवन? वी स्टडीड अ लॉट टुडे. हमने आज काफी लंबा पढ़ा है. We talked about the reason for success of Mendel. We talked about the why the choice of pea plant was successful. We understood the difference between trait and character. We observed what are the seven contrasting characters that was taken Mendel into consideration. And then we studied about definition of homozygous, heterozygous, recessive dominance, allele, homologous chromosomes, genotype, phenotype. और इसके अलावा भी हम एक बहुत मजेदार चीज जाने कि even if everything is made up of DNA, each one of them are carrying different meaning, gene, chromosome, chromatin, reticulum, etc. So any doubt regarding any of this point, anyone? Class?
No, ma'am.
So I will upload the lecture. Kindly go through it and let me know. We can discuss the doubt tomorrow. I am concluding the class here. Okay? Bye to all of you, beta. Have a very good night.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.